Good morning, Steve. This is Gary Birch, and I thought I would just respond to your letter and see if the following information may be able to help with what you're proposing there in the United States for adults on this autism spectrum in relation to everyday environments and so forth. First of all, I'll just give you a bit of an idea of what sort of things that I feel would be important for persons on the autism spectrum. I have served firstly on both a disability subcommittee as a staff representative, and I've also served as a workplace health and safety representative in work environments. And one of the things that I have noticed, and I think that needs careful consideration, is such issues as lighting in workplace health and safety, also sounds and sound and light sounds and lights, also access to buildings and so forth. So what I'll do is in 5 minutes I'll explain to you what I feel would be a requirement for persons on the autism spectrum, and then I'll try and attempt to cover what the letter that you've sent to me. Hopefully this might be able to help you with the information that you require in relation to why you contacted me. Well, the first thing I wanted to mention to you was that within a work environment, there can be issues with sound and sensory issues. Firstly, lighting always has to be efficient. It has to have more of a stationary sort of output of lighting. Fluorescent lights can often be difficult, and therefore there may be a need to factor in lighting that's less sensory aggravating. Other things also can relate to sound, like in bathrooms and in amenities, often very loud hand blowers and things like that can send people, including myself, into sensory issues, such as, you know, overstimulation. Also stairwells. Stairwells need to be insulated against sound and acoustics. So this can also cause issues if there's issues in relation to acoustics coming from stairwells. Also, lifts need to work and ensure that they work, and there needs to be regulations to ensure that if lifts aren't working, that there is actually the button that is in the lift is actually functioning, and the various persons can be contacted in the event of that lift breaking down. So this is another issue that also needs some attention. But basically, the infrastructure needs to be able to be supportive to people with all disabilities, and especially those with autism, so that people can actually get into buildings and can get around places without the need. Some people find driving is particularly difficult. Also, the issues of parking spaces, disability parking spaces can become difficult because often these can be used wrongly by other people and so forth. So these are some of the other issues that can relate to accessibility to buildings. So, and also there needs to be, and I think people on the autism spectrum can play a very valuable role in being workplace health and safety representatives because of our attention to detail and thoroughly checking all aspects of a work environment to ensure that it is compliant with occupational workplace health and safety regulations and requirements. So hopefully that will, it's given you a bit of an insight into that, into my, a bit of what I think and what I've been involved in. I've also wanted to just look at your email, and you said that you're in touch with a lot of organisations. I would be more than happy to be able to talk with you and provide ways and strategies to make work environments more conducive to persons on the spectrum. And one of the things that I do think is important is that the way that a person on the autism spectrum can function and perform in a work environment, and this may involve certain alterations in infrastructure and so forth, but the thing that is often difficult is that it can clash with work, you know, equal opportunity and those sorts of things, because people think that there might be a bit of favouritism if people on the spectrum are getting specialised sort of support in work environments. So these are some of the issues that need to be overcome and rectified wherever possible. And I think the thing is that in relation to sensory-friendly buildings, I think the important thing is to be able to have, first and foremost, a work environment that understands people on the autism spectrum. And this work environment needs to be able to not have bullying, not have a means of exploitation, and also there needs to be a feeling that when the person on the spectrum can enter that building, that the ability to be able to think and function is not hindered. And of course there are many things in modern buildings that can seriously impact upon the functioning abilities of a person on the autism spectrum, and this can include lighting, it can include poor access areas, it can also include a feeling of difficulty in being able to function on the social aspect, which we as persons on the autism spectrum encounter, because we have difficulty in being able to function on the social aspect. So the work environments need to be able to accommodate this, and this is probably a bit going more into a hypothetical sort of a discussion, but what I'm more or less saying is that to make a sensory friendly and a buildings that are stress reducing, first of all, there needs to be adequate lighting, there needs to be sound devices that don't overwhelm and cause meltdowns and sensory overstimulation. These can include hand dryers and can include other factors such as noisy areas in work environments and workspaces. Also, how to control sound in terms of coming out of people that may be accessing that building and so forth. So there might be a need for management, for example, to be able to ensure that within a workspace that these sort of requirements are adhered to, and this is something that needs, of course, a lot of attention to detail and focus. So once again, I can provide you with some feedback and some suggestions in relation to this, and I think across the whole disability group, including people with physical disabilities, I think that there also needs to be accommodations made for wheelchair access, and that we need to ensure that lifts are in working order and they are functioning, because it is a violation of rights for people with wheelchairs and physical disabilities if they cannot use and access lifts to buildings and these lifts are not working properly or functioning properly. So that is something that really needs to be safeguarded and implemented to ensure that that actually is functioning in a workspace. And I just wanted to suggest that if you want to contact me, I'm happy to talk to you more about this. And I am contactable on Skype, which is my name with a full stop in the middle. You guys call it a period. For us, it's just a full stop or decimal point. I'm contacted by that way. Also, I'm on Facebook. My name is, of course, Gary Burge, GARRYBURGE. I'd be happy to talk with you there. But Skype is a good means to be able to communicate, and I'm happy to assist you with that if that's required. I do have a lot of ideas for a sensory-friendly, stress-reducing building and work environment or public place, so I'm happy to be able to assist you with this as well, and we can hopefully talk more about this over Skype or via email or via Craig Evans, who from Autism Hangout, that put you in touch with me. I'm happy to talk with you and Craig, whatever, just to be able to help in this area. So hopefully this video today has been able to assist you on this very topic, and I would be more than willing and happy to support you in any further endeavours that you wish to undertake in relation to this very important area of need and concern. Thanks very much.